What up, what up? Winbush here. And today I'm excited to show you guys how we can do a cloth simulation inside of Cinema 4D, then natively bring it into Unreal Engine, no Alembic files needed in between. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. So right now I'm in the latest version of Cinema 4D. So I'm just gonna build this scene out really quick. So I'm just gonna use some simple primitives here. So I'm gonna come over here. I'm gonna come down to, let's say like landscape. Let's make this a little bit larger, maybe like 2000 by 2000. And then for like my width segments, I'm going to bring this up to 400. Maybe just, I'm going to bring everything up. And down here under borders at sea level, I'm just going to bring this up as well, because basically I'm just going to have my cloth fall upon this. So maybe for my scale, let's scale this up a lot larger. And right here in the middle, maybe like 150. And I want to have my cloth fall on this and basically interact with all these ridges here. So with this all set up, I'm going to come back over and I'm just going to make a plane. And then I'm going to bring my plane up a little bit higher. So again, let's make this maybe the same size, like 2000 by 2000. And then for my segments, I could bring the, you know what? We're going to Unreal. So let's do 200 by 200 for both of my segments here. And if I come over to display, let's look. We have a really dense mesh here, which should give us a nice cloth simulation. So I'm going to come back over here to display. We're just going to do a regular shaders here. And then right here under plane, I'm going to click on tag. And then I'm going to come down here under simulations and we're going to do a cloth simulation. Now for my landscape, we actually want to turn this into a collider. So again, simulation tags, I'm going to come over here to collider like so. And then with my plane selected, I'm going to click back on cloth, come down here to cache. And before I do this, let me actually make this scene 60 frames per second. So come up here to my render settings. For my frame rate, I'm going to click on 60. And then I'm going to hit Control D on my keyboard. Right here under my project, under FPS, I'm going to make this 60 as well. Maybe let's make this 300 frames just to give us a good duration there. And now I'm going to come back over here to my cloth tag. And for my plane, I'm actually going to make sure I have this selected. I'm going to hit C on my keyboard just to make this editable. I'm going to click on my cloth sim. Then I'm just going to cache this again. And there we go. So I'm going to click play. Let's play this through. So now we have our cloth simulation here again, and we have our editable plane. So I'm just going to actually rename this one to cloth like so. And then I'm going to come up here up top. I'm going to click on animate to bring me into this animate window. And then I'm going to take my cloth sim, just drag it down here underneath my dope sheet. And with this selected, make sure I'm on the first frame. I'm going to come right here to where it says functions. And I'm going to come down here to bake objects. Now with this selected, right here, I'm actually going to turn everything off. And then this PLA, I want to turn this attribute on right here. I'm going to leave everything else as default, 300 frames, and click OK. And now you see that it made a copy, but with all the keyframes in here. So the only one I want to keep is the one that has all the keyframes. So I'm going to come over, just delete the original cloth. You can keep it if you want, if you wanted to go back and do any changes or anything. But I'm basically happy with everything I have here. So now that I renamed this one to cloth, this was the copy. I could come back to my standard mode like so. And then I'm going to hit Control D on my keyboard. And that's going to bring up our attributes window down here for our project. And right here under Cineware, I'm going to select the cache polygon like so. Save animation. And I don't have a material. I'm not going to worry about that. We're just worried about the cloth sim. And then from here, I'm just going to save out my Cinema 4D file as I always do. So I'm just going to come over here to file. I'm just going to save project as. And then I'm just going to name this file cloth sim like so. And then I'm going to click on save, and that's going to be that. Now the next part is vital for this to work. So you want to install the Cineware for Unreal Engine plugin by Maxon. If you're not familiar with it, I'll run through it really quick here, but I do have several tutorials where I do a slower walkthrough. Now getting started, I'm on maxon.net right now, and I'm just going to come over here to where it says products, and down here at the bottom it says Cineware. And then I'm just going to scroll down until I see Unreal Engine, which is right here. And so I'm going to click on learn more. And then if I scroll down here to the bottom, this is where we have all the plugins. Now, the one that you want to use is the latest version right here. Installer for Windows, or if you use a Mac, you can use this one right here. But this is going to be the installer that you want to use, and make sure you have that installed before you open up Unreal Engine. Now, having this version of the Cineware plugin is vital because this is the only way that this next step is actually going to work. So right now I'm using Unreal Engine 5.2. And the first thing I want to do is make sure that that plugin installed correctly. So I'm going to come up here to edit. I'm going to come down here to plugins. And I'm just going to type in Cinema. And you should see this one right here, Cineware by Maxon. The latest version as of today is 2023.7. And then you want to make sure it's automatically turned on, which it should be already if you installed it using the installer. You don't want to use the Datasmith C4D importer. This one is the older version, which is no longer being updated. So again, Cineware by Maxon, make sure you're using this version right here and it's selected. So with that out of the way, I'm actually going to exit this out. And then I'm going to come over here to where we have this cube with the plus sign. I'm going to click on this. I'm going to come down to Datasmith, and then I'm going to do file import. And what that's going to do is open up this folder in which I have my Cinema 4D project right here. So I'm going to left click on this, and I'm going to click on open. And then it's going to bring up this importer folder. I'm just going to leave it at default, hit OK. And that's going to bring up this import options here, in which I'm going to leave everything on right here. Even though I don't have everything here, I'm just going to leave it at default. Texture resolution doesn't matter because I didn't bring over a texture, but you can do redshift textures as of today as well, which is cool. And then this is going to be an important one for geometry cache. I'm just going to leave all of these turned on, but you want to make sure you at least have this top one turned on. So if I turn it off, you see the other ones are grayed out. So you at least want to have import geometry caches turned on. And I'm just going to click on import. And this is going to start loading up the Cineware modules for us. And then after you do that, you should see this screen pop up. Now, the only one that has geometry cache that we're worried about is the cloth. So I'm going to select this one from my landscape. There is absolutely nothing going on with it, so I don't need to bring in a geo cache for my landscape, only my cloth. And then I'm going to come down here and click OK. And now you just wait for the frames to process out. And while this is processing, I want to take this moment to say, make sure you keep my channel on lock, because in the next few days, I'm going to have a big announcement concerning Redshift with Cinema 4D for Unreal Engine. We do have an update coming, so you want to make sure you got my channel unlocked. But enough about that. It looks like our cloth sim is finally imported into Cinema 4D. So I'm going to proceed on by coming down here instead of my content browser. Now you see we have this animation folder like so. And before I proceed, I'm actually just going to save all real quick just to make sure everything's saved out. And now I'm going to click on my animation folder right here. And you see that we have two sequencers. And so this sequencer is strictly only going to be the cloth. And then this one right here is going to be our main sequencer. So I could left click on this one, double click. And now if I just click play, you can see we actually have our simulation playing through inside of Unreal Engine. And this is all played through with no Alembic file at all. This is just brought over straight geocache from Cinema 4D. So let me play this again so you guys can see. So I thought that was really neat, and it's playing back really fast too. So I thought that was cool that we're able to do that without importing or exporting out Alembic files. And I can't wait to see what comes next with this next update, because we have some really cool functions coming with Redshift. So hopefully this tutorial helped you guys out. It's really quick and simple. No longer do we have to export out Alembic files. We can just use the Cineware plugin, which is getting better every day, to bring our cloth simulations into Unreal Engine. So if you did find this helpful, make sure you subscribe to the channel. As I said before, I do have some Cineware updates that are going to be coming in the next couple of days. Leave me a comment down below. Maybe you have some tips and tricks of your own. Always share them with me. I'm happy to receive them. And until next time, stay fresh, keep creating, and I'll catch you in the next video. I'll see you soon. Take care.